Like most things in life, there is commonly a downside. This course has been created to improve your privacy and security. The benefits are clear. You get protection from people, companies, and governments who unjustifiably want your information. Not to mention the benefits from fraud, identity theft, and other criminal activities. These are pretty awesome pros, but there are problems that are difficult to avoid, and this lesson will prepare you for the most common ones. Hello there, and thanks for watching Go Incognito. This course is entirely free, and one of the ways we can do that is through our many supporters who believe in our mission in spreading privacy and security to the masses. If you enjoy our work and want to help our cause, we have perks for supporters on Patreon and YouTube, and we recently introduced one-time donations through Ko-fi and PayPal. The latter needs no account on your end. We also accept Monero for those wanting to donate with the utmost privacy in mind. Thank you to all our current supporters, thanks to all of our future supporters, and thank you for watching the free course. Enjoy the rest of the lesson. The first and most obvious issue is your convenience will go down the drain. We talked about this in the very first section of the course. The more private and secure you get, the more inconvenient your life becomes. This is why I introduced all of you to the convenience line, an imaginary line to help you establish your limits. Another downside is you may come across as suspicious to employers and other people if they aren't able to find information about you online. Social media is a valuable tool when you post positive things you do, since it's a public way for people to learn more about you, and it doesn't limit you to just a piece of paper and a 10-minute interview. Obviously, this is terrible for your privacy, but be aware that some employers won't be thrilled when they can't conduct research under the table, whether or not you agree with that. Tying to that last point, you're not going to as easily be able to share your life with people you know. We always want people to see or react to major things we accomplish. It's human nature. Part of the reason we accomplish things is so that we can share our accomplishments. If you don't have social media, sharing your life events and accomplishments are much more difficult to do. The last downside is the possibility of obsession and/or phobia. It's not uncommon for everything we've discussed in the course to shock some people. As big as the problems we discussed in the course are, be grateful for the positives technology can bring into our lives. Being able to navigate anywhere in the world with Google Maps, instantly message people around the world, sharing moments with anybody instantly is plain awesome. There is a hidden dark side to it, but don't forget to enjoy the positives. I hope this has shed some light on the downsides to living a more private and secure life, but I also hope it doesn't discourage you from implementing a good amount of everything we've talked about. The benefits you'll get greatly outweigh the downsides, and there's always a middle ground. The question is, where is that for you? Make sure to stick around for the next lesson, which is the very last informational lesson of the course, and it's the most important. It talks about activism, advocacy, and things you can do to make an impact around you, hopefully convincing others to join the privacy and security movement. I'll see you then, and thank you for watching.